Scott's Geography Notebook.
Did you want to try saying it? Da, da, da.
We need to review a little bit about our adiabatic rates. And we've talked a little bit about one of these guys. And what we've been talking about so far is what happens when our air parcel is a dry air parcel. And in a dry air parcel, that means that our relative humidity is actually less than 100%. Okay? Now, we've looked at this already, and we realize that as an air mass begins to rise, it's going to be cooling. So it's going to be mass rises, it expands. And because it's expanding, molecules bumping less often, it cools. Okay. And that rate at which it is rising and expanding and cooling is going to be negative 10 degrees Celsius per 1,000 meters. So every time this parcel goes up, it's able to get bigger. And because it's getting bigger, it's going to be getting cooler and cooler and cooler. Now, the opposite can happen as well. If an air mass is forced to come down, if we have a high pressure system, or if the air is coming down off of a mountain, then the air mass is sinking, or it's forced downwards, it's going to be compressed and heats. What rate is that going to be happening at? Same thing. It's going to be happening at the rate of positive 10 degrees Celsius for every 1,000 meters that it goes down. Now, because this is dry, because relative humidity is less than 100%, we're going to be referring to this as our dry adiabatic rate. Or our DAR, and that has a value of plus or minus, whether it's getting warmer or colder, 10 degrees Celsius for every 1,000 meters that it either goes up or it goes down. What happens though if we have reached relative humidity of 100%? If it's reached 100%, then we either call that a wet parcel or a moist air parcel. Okay. This is going to be when relative humidity is equal to 100%. Okay. We've reached dew point temperature. We are starting to form clouds. And the big deal that we start to see here is that cloud formation, or that changing of form of the water from vapor to droplets. So what do we have in this rate? Well, the air mass is still going to be rising and it's cooling. That's going to be at negative 10 degrees Celsius for every 1,000 meters that it goes up. That's going to be the same thing that we were looking at before. However, now we have the latent heat of condensation. And we've got other videos that talk a little bit about that latent heat, but as the air goes from, or as that water goes from a vapor to liquid, it releases heat energy. The amount of heat energy approximately that gets released for that water that's going to be changing phase is going to be about 4 degrees Celsius for every 1,000 meters. So the air mass is rising and cooling at basically the same dry adiabatic rate, but now with this latent heat of condensation, if we combine both of these, then we get a net loss. Still is going to be getting colder, but not as quickly. This is going to be negative 6 degrees Celsius for every 1,000 meters that parcel goes up. Because of all of this, we use a different adiabatic rate. We refer to this as the moist adiabatic rate. That moist adiabatic rate, we'll say, is the MAR, and it is -6 degrees Celsius for every 1,000 meters.